What you'll learn about me is my background's very multidisciplinary.
So we can practice, sectioning with the saw.
Sure. So I'm an anatomist, I'm an anthropologist, I'm a biologist. I was always interested in doing something related to forensic science, and eventually I was drawn to bones. Most individuals are familiar with Bones, the TV show, and I always like to sort of start my lectures for students talking about some of the misconceptions that we might have from shows like that. We don't work in, you know, really fancy laboratories with hologram machines and backlit tables. We're not involved in the interrogation of suspects or the capturing of suspects or carrying guns. Forensic anthropologists are tasked with deciphering information from unknown skeletal remains. So basically any situation where you have human remains and they're not easily identifiable physically, we will assist police with identifying what's called a biological profile, determining the approximate age at death, the biological sex, stature or living height, as well as any evidence of disease or trauma to the bones. Forensic anthropologists never determines the cause of death. We describe what we're seeing and pass that information along. So I always say bones are a living record, and we can learn so much information from so little. Even just from sort of a very small piece, we can look at microscopy to tell age at death based on methods that are based on the principles of the turnover of bone that we experience over time.
This is one cross-section, so with this, we can create a three-dimensional render of this sample. So all these larger spaces here are the canals. That's where you'll have blood or nerves. And then all of these smaller spaces are spaces where cells live.
So from aspects of joint surfaces, closure of sort of bone caps that are open when your bones are growing, we can use clues from those features to help us identify approximate age range. And the pelvis is sort of our number one aspect of the skeleton we want, because age and sex are more straightforward to assess if you have something like this. A large proportion of the cases we see in forensic contexts are unfortunately marginalized individuals who often have substance abuse issues. And one of sort of the biggest issues with our methods is that we don't know how underlying biological processes affect those microstructural features. And this in turn is ending up resulting in older age estimates for people that likely are not. So somebody in their 20s to 30s might be overage to be 50s or 50 plus.
So this one, for example, this is a younger female that doesn't really look it. And you can see these huge resorptive areas.
So the current project then is to seek to develop a model of looking at sort of the prolonged impact of opioid use on that bone turnover process and how we can sort of refine the accuracy and precision of our age estimation methods that we use in forensic anthropology. Our primary role is to assist law enforcement in the recovery and analysis of human remains. So at the end of the day, we are aiming to bring closure to families who are missing loved ones.